Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways to make money online and also teach you how to become a work from home freelancer. So in the last few tutorials, I've been talking about different AI software and how we can use AI to make money online, to improve our business, create content, and so much more. So in today's tutorial, I want to give you a step-by-step demonstration of how we can use ChatGPT to help us with our business. This tutorial is for complete beginners. I'm going to talk about different writing prompts you can use and give you a basic overall demonstration of the capabilities of this amazing AI software. So first of all, in order to create an account, I will link you to this website in the description below this video. Now, sometimes it might be overloaded with requests because so many people are using it at the same time. And if you can't create an account now, just try again later. So here you'll click on sign up and basically you have to put in your email and you do have to verify it with a phone number. And once you have verified your account, this is ChatGPT right here. You have the option to choose light mode or dark mode, depending on what your preference is. And I'm going to teach you a little bit about what it can do. So down here is where you will ask ChatGPT to perform various tasks for you or ask it questions. First, I want to talk about the capabilities. One thing that's amazing about ChatGPT is it remembers what you said earlier in the conversation. So you could ask it to give you 10 different ideas for a YouTube video, and then you could ask it to expand on idea 2 or idea 3, and it will remember what you have said earlier in the same chat. So you can provide follow-up corrections. It's also important to note that it is trained to decline inappropriate requests. So if you ask it questions that are inappropriate or a little sketchy, it might decline to do what you want it to do. There are some limitations. Sometimes it might give incorrect information, so you might want to fact check it by going on Google, and it has limited knowledge of world and events after 2021. So don't ask it questions about stuff that has happened in this year, for example. It might not know. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is click here on new chat. So let's start a new chat and ask it a simple question. For example, how much does a panda bear weigh? Then we can click enter or click this icon here. So right now ChatGPT is thinking, so they just said a full grown giant panda weighs between 220 and 330 pounds. Let's say try again. I don't like the response. I want a better response or a different response. So now it's given me another response. They've decided to give it to me in kilos instead of pounds. So we can even ask it follow-up questions. Can you give me more information? And ChatGPT will remember what we were talking about. We're talking about the panda. So now they're going to give me a little bit of information about a panda, where it's from. You can even say, give me a joke about a panda. Why did the panda break up with his girlfriend? Because she was a very big eater and he couldn't afford to keep feeding her bamboo. So it really is amazing what ChatGPT can do and what it will remember. So what you can also do is, let's say I want to start a new chat. Rather than continuing here, I can go to the side and click new chat. And the panda bear conversation will be saved here. So we can go back to it at any time. We can even click on this edit icon and name it, you know, panda bear chat or whatever, and press the check mark, and now it's saved this chat. So let's start a new chat. Sometimes you might see this orange message pop up just saying they're experiencing high demand. You can still keep using ChatGPT, it just might be a little bit slower. So let's talk about things we can do with ChatGPT. Give me 3 different recipes for banana pudding. And it's just like that, it's given me 3 different banana recipes. Now I could say, give me an ingredients list to make recipe number 3. And it will literally just give me the ingredients that I need for that recipe. Okay, now let's try something different. I want to make dinner. I have lettuce, tomatoes, chicken breast, pasta, and cheese. Okay, so now they're giving me an idea for a recipe that I could use with the ingredients I've just said. Give me a salad dressing. And now it's given me a simple salad dressing recipe with these ingredients. Okay, what else can we do? We can also use ChatGPT to create original poems or short stories. Write me a cute Valentine's Day poem about a man who is a lumberjack who falls in love with a fisher woman. he meets in the forest. And it's creating this cute little poem. Roses are red, violets are blue. I met a fisherwoman and my heart skipped a beat for you. I was a lumberjack in the forest I'd roam, but your smile caught my eye and I knew I was home. It's just created me this cute little poem based on what I've asked it to. You could even ask it to create an original story for you. Write a short story about two cartoon characters who are both cats and they have to navigate the world of dogs and pretend to be dogs in order to survive. And their names are Harold and Jim. And they're literally creating a cute little story based on what I'm asking it to. And this story is original. What I can do to test that is I can copy a part of the story and go copy. Then I can go to Google. If you put in quotation marks and then paste it and then another quotation mark, it's going to search Google for that exact same paragraph and it hasn't found anything. So it's really amazing because you can use this for blog posts, to create poems or greeting cards that you sell on platforms like Etsy. Honestly, there are so many things you can do with this. Sometimes you have a great idea, you just don't know how to put it together. And then you can use this as a base to create your own story. Let's try something else. Create a PowerPoint presentation about the planet Jupiter. So let's say you're a teacher and you have to teach your kids about Jupiter or the solar system. You can literally ask ChatGPT to create you an entire PowerPoint presentation or outline, and it's going slide by slide. Let's click stop generating. Give me a script for slide number 2. Okay, so now they've given me an actual script if I wanted to do a video. Let's say, write a short paragraph about the composition of Jupiter. So here, rather than writing out a full script as if it's a video, they're giving me a paragraph. So this is something I could use in my PowerPoint presentation or if I was talking in front of people. You can even tell it, rephrase that so a 9-year-old child could understand. And it's literally taken this paragraph that had a lot of complicated words and rephrased it so that a kid could understand it. It's so amazing what this software can do. Okay, let's do a new chat and write me a resume. My name is Jennifer Marie. So just asked ChatGPT to write me a resume. I gave a little bit of information about myself and some of the things I know how to do. You could also tell that your hobbies, languages you speak, and right now it's thinking of a resume that I could use. And here it's just drafting me a resume that I could use and also providing me with space to add more skills, to add places where I've worked in the past. And you can even ask it to write you a cover letter. Write me a cover letter for a job as a voice over for a commercial based on my resume above. And they're literally using the information in my resume to write me a cover letter. And honestly, I don't think I could write a better cover letter myself. They're even including the software that I told them that I know how to use. So ChatGPT can just help you write the perfect cover letter for whatever job you want. You can even paste in the job that you're going for and say, write me a cover letter for this job based on my skills and write your skills. It's awesome. Okay, let's try something else. Let's say you want to become a YouTuber and you want to have a faceless YouTube channel. Give me a list of 10 different ideas if I want to start a YouTube channel and I don't want to show my face. Food or recipe channel, product reviews or unboxings, DIY or how-to tutorials, nature or travel vlogs. So now I've just said, give me 5 ideas for easy crafts I can make. So now I've said, write me an instructional script for how to make painted rocks. And they're literally saying, hi, welcome to this tutorial on how to make painted rocks. This is a simple and fun craft that you can do with just a few supplies. And so they're giving you basically a script that you could use in your YouTube video. Another thing ChatGPT is it can translate things for you. And I'm going to say, translate this into the following languages. So first it's going to translate this into French. Now I don't speak French, so I'm not sure how great it was. So you can see it's translating it into Italian and into Spanish as well. So let's click stop generating and let's try something else. So let's say someone has a pretty poor level of English and you want it to sound better. I've just put this in poor English. rewrite this in proper English. So it's just taken this, which has a lot of errors and mistakes, and it's rewritten it in proper English that sounds professional. So this can help you if you're applying to jobs or if you're talking to a client and your English isn't 100% excellent. You can also ask it to edit. Can you edit any errors, any grammar or punctuation errors in this text? Please highlight the errors as well. So you can see here, it has edited this sentence and it's also told us the errors. Now let's try something else. I have a friend of mine who is a coach and she uses this software to help her generate social media content for her coaching business. So let's say you are a weight loss coach. Give me 5 blog article ideas about how to lose weight in the new year. So now they've just given me 5 blog article ideas. We can also click here on regenerate response, and it's going to try again with 5 other ideas. And what you can do is you can go back and see which one you like, and you can just keep asking it to regenerate a response and flip through the different answers. Okay, so let's go back to this one, and now I'm going to say, write a full blog article about number 3. And now it's writing me a blog article that I can use on a website, top 5 at-home workouts for burning fat and losing weight. And it's generating an entire blog article for me that you can use. Of course, you can use this as a base. You can use this for ideas. I do think that human-generated content is probably better for SEO and Google. But in any case, this has given a great base, and you can change this up, make it sound more natural and more like your own voice. But what we can do is let's copy this to see if this is all original content. Going to go to Google, put a quotation mark, paste it, put another quotation mark, enter. And there are no results found for this exact phrasing, which means this is not like AI has copied and pasted these exact words. They have developed this on their own. So this is original content. These are just some of the things you can do with ChatGPT. It's absolutely amazing. It is helping people worldwide cut their workload in half or more. I have friends of mine using this to help them generate content for social media, for their coaching businesses. You can use this to help you proofread, to help edit better, content create, social media, you name it. It can do it. So I recommend you create an account with ChatGPT. There are some glitches. Sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not, but overall it's an amazing tool that you can use completely for free. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments section. I would like to do more videos on more advanced writing prompts so you can really maximize what ChatGPT can offer you to help you grow your own business. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let us know in the comments section if you've tried any cool writing prompts that other people might benefit from. And I will see you in my next tutorial.